So as of macOS version 10.13.6, that's the latest version of High Sierra, if you go into Photos, select some photos, and then create a new project to print something, like get prints or a book or calendar or cards, you get this message. The message is warning you that the print projects from Apple are going away. And the date of September 30th suggests that this is going to be gone from Mojave, so you won't be able to print anymore after September 30th of this year. So what do you do if you still want prints or you want those cool projects? Well, for a while now, Apple has allowed you to go and get third-party extensions for photos that allow you to print. This was a new feature a while back, and now we can see why, because Apple planned to pull out of this market and they wanted to enable third parties to keep extending this. So let's take a look at what's available. If we actually go and try to do this and say let's create some prints here, there's an Open App Store button. And the convenient thing about this is it takes you right to a section in the App Store that has products you can get that allow you to print directly from photos or order prints online. So you can notice there's a small selection here, but I predict there'll be a much larger selection. One of the things keeping companies out of this market is that most people are just going to go to Apple for prints and books and calendars and things. But once that's gone, people are going to have to go somewhere else. So there's going to be a much bigger market for these types of apps to thrive, and I expect all the different services that offer prints online to also offer a Photos extension. So I downloaded a bunch of different ones just kind of at random what was here. You could see here open, and open. These four that I downloaded. The other ones I can get. For the most part they are free because you're basically buying prints from these companies. So they of course can offer the apps for free. Once you download these, so you hit get and you hit install, you don't actually use the app itself for this. Instead, when you create a new project here, you'll see these appear here at the bottom. So here are the four that I downloaded. And if I wanted to go and use one, like I'll just choose this first one here, it creates a new project, asks me for permission there to access my photos, which is proper, and then it shows me all these different things that I could do with this particular service. Every service is going to be a little bit different. So Fujifilm service right here, I can order prints, I can do larger things like posters, I can do mugs, a bunch of different things, cards. There's a whole bunch of things I can explore. If I just want to do prints, I can click on prints here. I can select my type of print. I can see the prices are pretty comparable to what we've been used to. So we can do 4x6 prints. They're the photos that I had selected when I started, and I can edit to crop them and things like that. I can click the ones I want to order prints, and you can see it adds it to the bag there. And I can go and continue to cart. I can see that there. I can increase the quantity. I can check out, and it's going to ask me for payment information. I'm going to hit the Done button here to exit out of that, and you can see the project remains there on the side. We can try another one of these. So we'll try this one here, and a lot of them seem to have this interface here where you can kind of scroll through it there. So I can do photo books, I can do calendars, I can do cards. Let's try this one here. Has got framed prints, gallery wraps, metal, wood prints. So already we're seeing a lot more variety than we can find right now in the Apple products. So that's good. And Shutterfly, of course, is pretty well known online. But all they have here so far are books. But I think we're going to see companies like that adding more potential products. A lot more companies entering the App Store with their products there so you can print directly from photos. I haven't tried any of these. I haven't tried ordering to see the quality, so I'll be interested in hearing feedback if you've used any of these services or tried some of the others. And over the next 6 months or so, I think I'll probably do some orders with various companies and I'll report what I have found in terms of quality.